My main hero when I was growing up was John Wayne, because I loved the way he was in his westerns, and his movies itself inspired me. I just loved the guy. I wish I could have met him before he passed away. My other hero was Audie Murphy from World War II. His action to receive the Medal of Honor, and that really inspired me to go into the military.
On November 5, 1966, Private First Class John Baker Jr., an assistant machine gunner, found himself in Tay Ninh Province in Vietnam. Company A of the 27th Infantry had been assigned to rescue a sister company trapped by an ever-growing number of Viet Cong. By the time Baker and his group arrived, the enemy numbered nearly 3,000.
One of our platoons was out on a night ambush patrol, which is, recovers about 13 to 14 men. Usually we go out on helicopters early in the morning, and they set us down about maybe 10, 15 miles out. And then we scoured the woods and jungle types to raid out the Viet Cong. Our mission was to get one of our elements out of the woods. They were trapped. We had an estimate about 300 hardcore VC. They had them trapped. And our mission was to go in there the next morning and try to get them out of there. So we started out with 257 of us going in the jungle that morning. And the jungle itself was so thick, it looked like going in the wooded area at night. We had one man that took his gear off and crawled up in front and seen what was going on in the wooded area, and he got pretty well shot up. And we ran up against an element of a 3,000 hardcore VC. So I went up there and took my stuff off and crawled up about 20 yards in front of him. And there was a lot of cement bunkers. And so I went back and told my CO, and then all hell broke out. They started firing right from the left to right behind us. We were trapped ourselves, and the only way we could get out was fight our way out. Our men would get pulled right and left. So my company commander is Robert F. Foley, took the right side and I took the left, and I went in there and knocked out a couple bunkers, and then I had one man get wounded, and I carried him back to the rear and replenished my ammo and went back in and killed a few more snipers. When you see your buddies get killed, sometimes you lose your mind, and you're trained to do what you have to do to survive. You just have that certain moment and that certain burst of energy to get in there and take care of the situation, and that's what we did.
Baker was wounded by shrapnel from a grenade explosion, but got up and continued to fight, pulling injured soldiers off the battlefield and destroying two more bunkers. At the end of the battle, Baker had killed 10 Viet Cong, destroyed 6 bunkers, and saved the lives of 8 of his fellow soldiers.
We finally broke through the lines and made a pathway so we can get our wounded out of there. By the time we were ready to take us out of there by choppers, 101st Airborne came in, Big Red 1 came in, we had the whole 25th Infantry Division coming in to help us out. It seemed like forever, but it was only an hour and a half. After I left Vietnam, I was a drill sergeant at Fort Jackson, South Carolina. And one day my company commander came out in the field and told me that the President of the United States was on the phone and wanted to talk to me. And when I got back to the orderly room, it was President Johnson, and he said I'd be coming to the White House for a ceremony to receive the Medal of Honor. Captain Foley, he received it the same time I did for the same action. And he's 6'7", I'm 5'2". And President Johnson, when he put the medal around us, called us Mutton Jeff. So it was a real impressive ceremony. And you just have that moment in life, no matter who you are, if you're a fireman or any type of worker, and you see somebody get hurt, you need to get in there and get them out. there's all types of heroes. So you have the heroes in sports. And my heroes are the guys that received the medal. They each have their own fantastic story, and they're just plain humans, just like I am. It just makes you proud to be American.